The interaction between kinetics and thermodynamic equilibrium is quite important in carrying out chemical reactions. In particular, it's important to understand what effect the catalyst can have on equilibrium. So a catalyst cannot change the ultimate equilibrium for a system, but, and this is really important, it can selectively accelerate the rate of one reaction or more than one reaction that's thermodynamically favored, such that when we calculate equilibrium, we can only take into account some of the possible reactions. This is a very important property of catalysts. Let's look at a couple reactions of carbon monoxide and hydrogen to make alcohols. So I've listed the reaction to make methanol and the reaction to make ethanol from carbon monoxide and hydrogen. And notice the equilibrium constant for making ethanol is almost 5 orders of magnitude higher. And so we expect that if we carry out both these reactions and we get close to equilibrium, then we're going to form predominantly ethanol. And indeed, we'll do the equilibrium calculations. Well, I won't go through the calculations or other screencasts that show how to do that. I'll just give you the results here. So here's the case if we were to feed a 50-50 mixture of CO and hydrogen to a reactor, 500 Kelvin, and typically we carry out these type reactions to higher pressures, in this case 20 bar, because gas phase reactions, the number of moles is decreasing with reactions, so higher pressures are going to favor the products. So if we could carry out the reaction that went to equilibrium, listed here, what's the composition leaving? You'll see that most of the hydrogen has reacted because of the equilibrium constant of the second reaction. And because of the stoichiometry, half of the carbon monoxide has reacted, essentially. The important thing to notice is that we make almost no methanol. So the main product is ethanol, as we would expect from equilibrium constants, and we're just looking at equilibrium composition. So the advantage of a catalyst now is if we can find the right catalyst that makes the first reaction take place, but not the second reaction, then we have the potential that we can calculate equilibrium just considering the first reaction. So let's look at those numbers. The question we really want to answer is how could we make methanol on a large scale from CO and hydrogen based on the calculations we just did? The answer is if we can find the right catalyst, we can do this because indeed methanol is made this way on a large scale. So here, same reaction conditions and same feed, but if I do the equilibrium calculation only considering the reaction to make methanol, now you see that we have a methanol mole fraction that's reasonable, more than 3 orders of magnitude higher than in the case where we have both reactions in our calculation. And so what the catalyst allows us to do is to consider just one reaction because the other reactions are sufficiently slow. You know, if we wait it forever, of course, we get equilibrium where we'd have to consider all the reactions. But we can just consider this one reaction, and we can make methanol on a large scale this way. Now, typically, we're always doing this of just considering some reactions because when I've showed these two reactions, I've ignored the possibility that CO plus hydrogen can react. So let's see, 3 hydrogen plus CO can make methane plus water. And that has a significant equilibrium constant. Also can make ethane and propane, butane, etc., with different catalysts. And so this idea of only considering some reactions is something we typically do without actually thinking about it. But it makes a huge difference and is the real advantage of a catalyst to pick out some reactions to selectively make them go towards equilibrium.